Hello, today we will take a closer look at the new Express LRS receiver from Beta FPV, the SuperP 14-channel diversity receiver. For some time now, I have basically switched entirely to Express LRS, whether in airplanes or multirotors. However, it's only recently that the receivers with PWM outputs in enclosure have started to appear. This was particularly lacking, especially when building big fixed-wing aircraft, where it's more convenient to use a larger, more robust receiver in a casing instead of relying on small receivers. Additionally, thanks to the PWM outputs, we can now widely use it in models where we don't use a flight controller but want to directly connect servos or other mechanisms. You can find the link to this receiver in the video description. Receiver is available in 2.4 GHz, 915 and 868 MHz versions. I have 2.4 GHz version. It supports PWM, Crossfire and SBUS protocols with 14 PWM pins. It also features an RGB LED that indicates the receiver states and packet rate. In the package, we have the receiver itself, an Y servo cable, a 3-pin cable for the RGB and 4-pin cable for the I2C port and a V-bud sensor cable. Let's take a closer look at the pin configuration. We have the classic 10 PWM outputs, which is sufficient for most applications, even with extensive mechanization and multiply servos. Additionally, channels 11 and 12 are set as the default I2C port. Channels 13 and 14, along with the VBUD sensor, are located at the top. On the other side, we have a USB-C port, which is a convenient feature for easy connection to a computer and powering the receiver. This simplifies the firmware updating process. There is also a LED indicator that shows the status and packet rate. The receiver is a true diversity with two antennas. This receiver offers few channel mapping modes. You can have all 14 PWM channels, use I2C with 12 PWM channels, or use SBUS or Crossfire protocols to connect to a flight controller. Channels 13 and 14 are designated for that purpose. These modes can be configured through the setup web page. By default, after powering up the receiver, after 60 seconds, it enters Wi-Fi mode. Then you can connect to the Express LRS network, and you will be automatically redirected to this setup page. Access the page at this address. There you can assign channels and change other options. By default, pins 19 and 22 are assigned to SDA and SCL. In this mode, Crossfire or SBUS output are not available. To change that, you need to remove the assignment for SCL and SDA and insert pins 19 and 22 into the PWM channel list, then save the changes. The receiver will reboot and you need to access the setup page again. This time, in the Model tab, you will see the full 14 PWM channels. You can swap channels 13 and 14 to Serial TX and Serial RX. It opens up the option to select the communication protocol with the flight controller. For example, choose Crossfire and then you can connect it to the flight controller. The receiver comes with eLRS 3.3.0 firmware without any binding phrase. However, you can set a binding phrase on both the receiver and the transmitter. By default, you can bind it in the traditional way. To enter binding mode, power up the receiver 3 times in quick succession. It's indicated by fast double blinking of the orange LED light. Then, using the ALRS Lua script on your transmitter, enter binding mode and after a few seconds the binding process will be completed. Another interesting feature is VBUD sensing, which supports batteries from 1 to 6S. By connecting the positive and negative leads to the battery balance port, you can receive voltage readings in telemetry on your transmitter. In conclusion, this receiver appears to be a good and reliable option. It will be especially useful for fixed-wing aircraft. Express LRS is becoming a leading RC link system due to its easy availability, open source, cheap equipment and long-range reliability. It's great to see new hardware components emerging for the Express LRS system. I will soon test this receiver in flight for my upcoming project. Let me know what you think about this equipment and whether you have already switched to Express LRS or are using a different system. See you soon!